Have you ever wondered how dynamic applied to the motion or rigid bodies? If you want to learn, come with us to figure it out. There will be three learning outcomes we will obtain from the application of dynamic by playing netball. The first one is solve dynamic problem of accelerating particles, and the second one is solve problems of accelerating rigid bodies in two dimension, and the last one is analyzing kinematic and kinetic problems in vibrating particles.
Hello everyone, I am Amel Zubaydi. I will explain about LO1, which is about solve dynamic problems of accelerating particles. As we see here, when the girl throw the ball upward, the maximum height of the ball, which is the displacement, and the time taken to return the ball to the original position are unknown. And we have the initial velocity, which is equal to 5.9 meter per second, and the final velocity is equal to zero. Also, we have the acceleration is equal to negative of gravity, which is -9.81 meter per second squared. These are two equations of linear motion we will use to find the time and the displacement. As we have the V0 is indicate to initial velocity, V indicate to final velocity, T indicate to time, S indicate to displacement, and A indicate to acceleration. The parameter which are given are the final velocity is equal to zero, initial velocity equal to 5.9 meter per second, and the acceleration is equal to 9.81 meter per second square, and we have to find the displacement and the time. Firstly, to find the time, we have to use this equation, which is the final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration multiplied by time. By substitute the value and try to solve the equation, we find the time is equal to 0.6 seconds. Secondly, to find the displacement, we use this equation, which is the displacement equal to initial velocity multiplied by time plus half of acceleration multiplied by time square. By directed substitute the value and solve the equation, we get the displacement is equal to 1.77 meter.
Hi, my name is Asia binti Muhammad Ashraf. Now, I will be discussing on the LO2 part, which is to solve dynamic problems of accelerating rigid bodies in two dimensions. This diagram shows the projection of the ball when person A passes it to person B. The initial position of the ball is denoted by A, the final position of the ball is denoted by B, and the maximum height traveled by the ball is denoted by C. The maximum height and the time of flight is unknown. The range of the ball traveled is 2 meters. This is the free body diagram of the ball. The force acting on the ball is the gravitational force that is equal to 9.81 meter per second square. The initial velocity of the ball is 3 meter per second. From this, the velocity can be divided into two components, which are the x component and the y component. By using the coordinate system, we can find the velocity of x component, which is 2.82 meter per second, and velocity of y component, which is 1.03 meter per second. Next, we will use the kinematic equations to solve the maximum height and time of flight. To find the maximum height, we can use the third equation from y component. The velocity of y component at point C is zero. Vcy is the velocity of y component at point C. Vay is the velocity of y component at point A. Using the formula, we will get a value of 0.05 meter. For the time of flight, since the maximum range is known, we can find it using the first equation of x component. Xb is the distance projectile launch from initial point to point B. Xa is the initial point. Vax is the velocity of x component at point A, while Tab is the time of flight from point A to B. Using the formula, we will get a value of 0.71 seconds. Thank you. That is all from me.
Hello everyone, so in this part, I'll be presenting about LO2, which is to solve dynamic problems of accelerating rigid body in two dimensions. These are the kinematics equation for projectile motion. The above one is for horizontal motion, and the below one is for vertical motion. At the first attempt, the ball was projected 7 meters per second squared and 60 degrees from point A. Okay. From the given information, we get to calculate the x component and y component of velocity. From the x component of the velocity, we get to figure out the time of the ball projected from point A to point before B using horizontal equation. We also can get the maximum height of the ball projecting from point A to point B using the vertical equation. While at the second attempt, the ball was projected 8.45 meters per second squared and 60 degrees from point A. We were using same degree but higher velocity value. Higher velocity value gave us higher maximum height of the ball value, which then we could go the ball into the net.
Hello everyone, my name is Nuratila Binti Hamid Shambli. My matrix number is U2103133. So now I will explain about LO3, which to analyze kinematics and kinetics problem in vibrating particles. So ball bounce by me hit into the ground and bounce several times until it stops. Distance of the ball from me is 1 meter. Initial height of the ball from the ground is 0.5 meter. While initial velocity and the angle of ball being bounced from horizontal component is 5 meter per second and 20 degree respectively. So, we need to find what is the velocity of the ball after it bounces and angle of the ball, which is delta A. So first, we have to identify final velocity and the landing angle delta F of the ball. So the final velocity can be resolved in two components, which is F, Fx, and Fy. For the horizontal component, the Vix equals to Vfx, which is initial of velocity is 5. So 5 cos 20 degrees is 4.70 meters per second. So for the vertical component, we know that Vy equals to Ay multiplied by T. Like in all the data, and we will got negative 13.01 meters per second. So for Vf, we have to square root 4.70 to the power of 2 plus negative 13.01 to the power of 2, and we will get 13.83 meters per second. And for delta F, we gotta do tan negative 1 and multiply by negative 13.01 over 4.70, and we will get negative 70.14 degrees. Next, to find the velocity after the ball bounce is to find the horizontal component of Va, which Vrs, which we can use formula mv1 equals to mv2. We substitute the value and we will get Vrs equals to 4.70 meters per second. So for the vertical component, we can use the coefficients of substitution, which we assume the coefficients is 0.1. Substitute all the values and we will get Vay equals to 1.301 meters per second. Lastly, for the Va and delta F, we also use the same formula as the calculation previous, which is a Va we will get 4.878 meters per second, and while delta F we will get 15.47 degrees.
I hope you get benefit and enjoy with us. Thank you.